With legislation set throughout Europe to ban the sale of petrol and diesel cars as early as 2035, car manufacturers have had to change strategies, research and develop new technologies, and begin the shift to electric vehicles. For an industry with a history of producing combustion engine-based cars, in some cases for over a century, this is no easy task. But with the global challenge we face tackling the climate emergency, changes have to be made. Competing in Formula E is a big step for R&D and raising awareness of the technology's potential, but more will need to be done to be in with a chance of reaching the targets laid out. So, what are some of the world's most established manufacturers doing to make the biggest shift in the history of the industry? So, starting with the first of four German giants we'll talk about in this video, BMW were early adopters of electric technology, releasing one of the first mass production models on the market in 2014 with the BMW i3. 6 years on, with the i3 going from strength to strength over seven versions, the manufacturer is increasing their offering with the Mini Electric and the BMW iX3 this year, and the iNext and i4 in 2021. And, supposedly, 12 more models by 2025. But it isn't just about the power source of the cars they are selling. Huge changes are needed throughout the entire production process and life cycle of the vehicles produced to reduce emissions. By the end of 2020, BMW aimed to be using power only from renewable energy across all of their production facilities worldwide, improving on the 80% from renewable sources they've had since 2018. So how do they intend to do this? Well, BMW's solar site in Chennai, India already supplies more than 26% of their global energy needs, and the Spartanburg location in the US obtains its electricity by processing heat from waste produced at a neighboring landfill site, avoiding over 46,000 tons of CO2 emissions per year. And as far as life cycle improvements go, BMW claim that the lithium-ion batteries used in their EVs are fully recycled at the end of their use, and 99% of waste material from production is recycled and reused. It's looking like their early entry into the electric vehicle market and the years of development and learning since then are paying off, putting BMW well on track with their targets. Another German giant and veteran manufacturer in Formula E, Audi are making big plays to showcase their commitment to electrification. Their flagship electric vehicle, being the e-tron, released in mid-2019, has proved to be popular amongst EV drivers and reviewers alike. 2020 looks to bring with it a few more models, with the e-tron Sportback and S-Line Power Boost editions of the e-tron and e-tron Sportback, plus an Audi Q4 e-tron and 30 other electric or hybrid models by 2025. On the manufacturing emissions front, Audi's Brussels production facility, home of the e-tron, has been powered entirely by renewable energy since 2012, and a solar PV system installed shortly after, the largest in the region, allows the plant to avoid releasing 17,000 tons of CO2 into the atmosphere every year, the equivalent annual footprint of 1,500 people. Audi's environmental program, Mission Zero, sets out to make all of the sites worldwide carbon neutral by 2025. Daimler, the parent company for Mercedes-Benz and Smart Car, regardless of the premium side of the business getting into electrification slightly later than their rivals, are now hitting the ground running. Parent to another German giant, Daimler are investing heavily into expanding their electric fleet, 10 billion euros to be precise, with 1 billion going into the development of battery technology and production. Fully electric cars currently on sale include the Smart EQ 42 and 44 and the Mercedes-Benz EQC SUV, with the 8-seater EQV MPV coming later this year. Daimler plan to launch more than 10 all-electric cars in all segments by 2025. But where Daimler and Mercedes differ from other manufacturers is the other types of vehicle they produce that have a much wider impact on other industries, such as buses, trucks, and vans. Daimler plan to include these other vehicle types within their development and production investment. And with the positive impact this technology could have on things like haulage and public transport, the emission reductions can spread far wider than consumer cars alone. This growth in all areas of electric mobility and the requirements associated will likely bring a number of challenges with them. The raw materials needed for production will be in high demand, which could result in a different kind of environmental stress. So to combat this, Daimler are setting themselves the objective of reducing the amount of materials needed and ramping up their recycling processes for things like batteries. The idea being to increase the energy that the batteries can hold, meaning a lower total weight and less materials needed to manufacture them. Renewable energy, including solar, wind, and hydropower, will be used to make all of the manufacturing plants in Germany carbon neutral by the end of 2020, with a host of CO2 neutral plants being built around the world as well. With the way they entered Formula E, it's no surprise that Porsche have grand ambitions to stamp their mark on the EV world. Rocketing their way into full electrification with the Porsche Taycan and challenging the performance status quo, including the likes of Tesla, with a 0 to 100 km per hour in 2.8 seconds, with an impressive range of 256 miles. Soon to follow in 2021 will be a four-wheel drive Taycan Cross Turismo with off-road ability, but Porsche's EV offering won't be limited to the Taycan range, as the next generation of Macan SUV is rumoured to be exclusively sold as a battery-powered model, and full EV Cayman and Boxer sports cars are expected to follow around 2023. Production energy-wise, the Taycan is produced using 100% green energy and is a carbon-neutral model. Porsche are consistently cutting the levels of CO2 emissions from their fleet and production processes as they continue to pump out more hybrid and fully electric models. British car maker Jaguar Land Rover have had a reasonably subtle entry into the EV market in terms of the number of models or model available, but not quiet by any means. Their first full electric offering, the Jaguar I-Pace, has been a resounding success, being coveted as not only World Car of the Year, but also World Car Design of the Year and World Green Car in 2019. The first car to win all three categories in the same year. Jaguar have said its next zero emissions vehicle will be the pure electric version of the next XJ limousine. And after the hype of the I-Pace, expectations are high. Even though the manufacturer only currently offer a handful of hybrids and one full electric model, JLR have stated that from 2020, all new vehicles will offer the option of hybrid or full electrification. Their UK facilities, including product creation and development sites, assembly plants, and satellite sites, operate as carbon neutral with 100% of electricity coming from renewable energy, and they've been recognised as carbon neutral by the Carbon Trust for the second consecutive year. The PSA Group, parent company to the likes of Citroën and DS Automobiles, powertrain supplier to championship-winning Formula E team DS Techeeta, have their own set of targets regarding carbon neutrality. 2019 saw DS's first all-electric offering with the DS3 Crossback E-Tense, with the idea of bringing electric cars into a new era of affordable luxury. From 2025 onwards, all new DS models will be available exclusively in electrified versions, starting with 2019's DS3 Crossback E-Tense and the recently released DS7 Crossback E-Tense 4x4 Hybrid. When it comes to reducing the emissions further and from the production process, DS are taking action in several areas, including weight control, powertrain technology, and aerodynamics, and are committing to building vehicles with 30% recycled or biosourced materials. Two of their manufacturing plants are already powered by 100% renewable electricity, and the lost heat from the PSA foundry in Charleville, where a lot of the group's metalwork is produced, is collected and transferred to heat nearby buildings, which generated a reduction in CO2 emissions by 7,000 tons in 2018. These European manufacturers have begun their transition to carbon neutrality, but with the current target starting to seem too generous, we may see the timeline shrink and more drastic changes to strategy and production be implemented. So now it's up to the manufacturers which side of history they want to be on.